going into the boxing world. We have a very good, we had a very good heavyweight weekend this weekend. Third, I'm just over here putting up my, what you call it, third in a row. Ice cold pick three, third in a row. Okay, so pretty much we are here, and we have Big Baby Anderson stays undefeated after thorough beatdown of Rudenko with fifth round TKO. The fight was really boring. Like, let's keep it real. And it was like a night full of weird situations. But as you guys can see, he came out with the Batman look. You know what I mean? I kind of felt like, you know, we've been doing a lot of these masks and everything like that. I think he came out as the Grinch one fight. He came out as his school mascot his last fight. Came out with a pimp hat one fight in New York. And now he came out with a Batman mask. And I was like, I know what he's trying to, you know, get that viral moment and get people to really, you know, really be like, who's this dude? And everything like that. But this one was kind of silly. It made, he kind of looked a little bus ready. You know what I mean? With this one, you know what I mean? I know you're trying to entertain. You're trying to be different, all that good stuff. But you know what? This is just a very easy way to get cooked by goofy people like myself. So, you know, pretty much it was a good idea, though. Let's just say that it was a great idea, but I think it kind of missed. I think he missed that free throw by an inch or two. You know what I mean? Because it just didn't seem right. It didn't look right. And the guy he was going against was almost like, when you know Batman's beating up one of the extras, you know, like when you wear the Batman fit, you going out there to go whoop on the Joker. You go out there to go beat up on Bane. You know, somebody that's going to give you fits tonight. Man, this dude went out there and literally was hitting a punching bag. That guy was okay. He had some good technical skills, Rudenko, because he's Ukrainian. But at the same time, he was just overmatched by Big Baby Anderson. And this was the type of fight they should have matchmaked for him when he was in Ohio. When he did his homecoming fight, he needed to have a guy like Rudenko who was knockout ready for him. You know what I mean? To where you can stop the fight. They put him in there with Charles Martin. That fight almost went, that fight damn near went life and death. You know what I mean? But he kind of needed to have that moment to show that, okay, the guy's not invincible. The guy has things he has to work on. And pretty much he worked on all that stuff. But I felt like he didn't really care in this fight because he knew that he was going to cook this guy. And that's absolutely what he did. But one thing that he did say after the fight, it was very intriguing, where he was talking about that he's in it for the money. He doesn't care how he looks. As long as he wins the fight, it doesn't matter. And when you start talking with that type of attitude, you're pretty much telling us, or telling me, that, you know what, I'll go in here and I'll get overpaid to get knocked out by a champion. You know, I'm not worried about winning championships. I'm not worried about being a legend in this sport. I just want money. And you know what? These guys, today he'll say that, but next week he'll say he didn't mean that, you know? Because at the end of the day, when you get to the heavyweight ranks, you are in it for the money. But if you're a top heavyweight, a heavyweight with some real, real pop to you and some real movement to you, then you're going to want to be a world champion. It's not because the money comes with being a world champion. The money doesn't come with being a guy who can knock out a bunch of bumps every 6 weeks and be a prospect for the next decade. No, you have to put yourself in the fire at some point. And I feel like he could be one of the guys that's next up for one of these belts, or possibly for the next Usyk opponent, because I feel like Usyk really does need to fight somebody like this. Because Dubois IQ wasn't there. We're going to talk about that in a second. But still, Big Baby Anderson, I think that he's about two fights away from a title fight. And he has to have two tough fights, in my opinion, as well, too. So it would be great to see him fight against one of these top-ranked heavyweights that they feel is, you know, superb and is to the next level. I'm thinking to myself, he possibly gets F.A. Ajaba in his next fight. That could possibly be a fight right there. Or he could go ahead and fight the guy that he was supposed to fight in Ohio who fought Ajaba. But that guy lost because of a low blow. That guy lost because he kept low blowing and literally grabbed F.A.'s private parts on the last one because he didn't want to be there. And you know what? The guy wasn't even really that good, but I know since he's from Kazakhstan, where Triple G is from, they'll overhype the situation, you know, accordingly. So pretty much maybe he'll get that fight. Maybe he'll get the Ajaba fight. Possibly they might say, do you want to fight Charles Martin again and rematch? Because I know Charles Martin said on TV that night, yeah, he did a good job, but I know Charles Martin felt like he won that fight. You know what I mean? So, you know, that could be something that could work out as well too. But I truly do think that he is in line to get his championship opportunity. I think that though he just has to wait out these next fights from the top dogs and just keep fighting himself. But he needs to fight two step-up fights. No more of this, you know, showcase fight. We bring him in because it's the main event, all that good stuff. You have to bring in a guy that is chasing that title as well, too. I would love to see Jeremiah Milton possibly fight Big Baby Anderson on the next run. And that would be a nice little fight. And then here goes a fight that will crack all of us up. Even though I know they probably won't let him fight Big Baby Anderson, but he does have a record to where the commission could approve him. Chris Lovejoy, that would be a lot of fun. Chris Lovejoy could sell a whole lot of tickets in a fight with Big Baby Anderson. I know it sounds really silly today, but just listen to me. If he was to book a fight with Chris Lovejoy, that would probably be the most hyped fight he ever had because Chris Lovejoy knows how to sell a fight. And one more option for Big Baby. He needs to fight Big Baby Jarrell Miller for the true title of Big Baby, because before Big Baby was a pro, Jarrell was Big Baby. He was seen as the next one up. He was going to fight Anthony Joshua, and he got caught with steroids. So pretty much they need to get it on because he's fixed all that stuff. He's fighting again, and I would love to see Jarrell Miller and Big Baby Anderson fight for the Big Baby nickname, and whoever loses can't use that nickname no more. How about that? That makes a whole lot of sense. That's the right type of fight. That's a good grudge match right there. All right, so let's go ahead, move forward to our next topic.